Okay, so I hear that the beginning of this season contains, and this is a quote, lots of tranny prostitutes.
Lots of tranny prostitutes?
Would that be a fair assessment of the beginning of this season?
Well, I don't think so, not that I recall. There may be a couple, sure, but not lots.
Oh, so, okay, we're quibbling over lots versus a couple here. Okay.
Well, I mean, a hundred's a lot. A hundred's a lot. A couple is not a lot.
You'd have to save the 100 for sweeps, probably.
Yeah, right. The 100 might be for sweeps, babe.
Over the years, what do you think the takeaway from the show? How do you think it's changed?
I hope that people will watch the show and learn something from it as well as being entertained from it. And I think Cops is very entertaining and should be entertaining, but it should also be a little bit revealing about human psychology, about our laws, about where crime takes place, about what goes on in your own backyard. All of these kinds of social, psychological, and legal issues are there if you just kind of watch the show and think about it a little
bit. Well, it depends who's watching, though. That's what's great about Cops, right?
Well,
You got everybody from the guys in prison watching it to the academics watching
right.
the show.
Right. So. Listen, we have academic studies on Cops and the socio-psychological, legal aspects of Cops, the TV program.
They're horrible.
And they are.
Horrible.
They're very dry and boring. And then you have the good old down-home prisoner watching TV in the day room, and if anybody dare changes the title, he'll shank them. I mean, this is true. It's big in prisons and jails. So, I think that's the virtue of Cops. It appeals to a wide range of
viewers. Cops and criminals have in common? They both love the show, right?
Has that changed, though? Do you think one group has, that things have tilted at all over the years?
No. I think I pretty much see the same cross-section of viewers on Cops as I've always seen.
But it's sort of become a badge of honor, almost, being on
to
Cops,
be on
which,
Cops?
Yes. Which was
well,
clearly not the case
okay,
when
well,
it started.
That's a good point.
But that has to do with other factors in society. I think that we've become such a reality star-driven culture.
It was the idea that the common man could now become a reality
a celebrity,
star, right?
Right.
So in turn, now we see on Cops that everybody who...
The common criminal wants to be a reality
Everybody who
star.
Appears, they sign the release very enthusiastically, and they ask us if we could please follow up and let them know when their segment's going to appear. Because that is
and
where
they can
we
tell
are.
Their mom.
That's where the culture is.
Okay, but the first time someone said that to you, how did you react?
It has changed. In the early days of the show, it was you saw the pixelated faces in
sure.
the early days. We don't do that anymore. And I don't know how to explain
it.
Of
course, you never saw a pixelated face on Cops. By the way, I always blur them.
Yeah,
the Magritte technique.
It's blurred. It's blurred.
Big difference.
It is blurred.
Let's say you guys forget to pay some parking tickets. What would you guys do when they come for you?
I would pay the parking ticket because they're ruthless and they're not going to let me off because they do Cops.
Right, but would you sign the release?
Would I sign? Yeah. Why not?
I think I'd probably
I appreciate
sign,
television.
Yeah. I think I would probably sign the release.
Why not?
Excellent.
What's to lose?
Well, thank you guys so much.
It was a parking ticket.
Yeah.
It wasn't homicide.
You could have done something worse. I don't know.
If I had a crack pipe in my hand.
Then I might not die. If I had a smoking gun in my hand or a bloody knife, maybe not.
Good to know there are limits. Thank you guys very much.
Thank you. Right. Appreciate it.